कंटिन्यूइंग द टॉपिक पार्टिसिपेशन थ्रू वोटिंग. सो स्टूडेंट्स, वी नो वेरी वेल दैट पीपल मेक अ डिसीजन इन डेमोक्रेसी. मे बी द क्वेश्चन रेज इन योर माइंड दैट हाउ पीपल मेक अ डिसीजन इन डेमोक्रेसी. यस, नॉट डायरेक्टली बट इनडायरेक्टली पीपल मेक डिसीजंस इन डेमोक्रेसी. सो हाउ? थ्रू द वोटिंग इन इलेक्शन पीपल इलेक्ट देयर लीडर्स. And these representatives, these leaders take a decision on behalf of the people in the parliament. Whatever the issues regard to the people, they raise their voice or they raise that issue in the parliament, and through this way, this elected representative take a decision on behalf of the people. So students, is it continuing? No, it is only elected 5 years. So students, once elected government can stay in a power for that period only, they cannot continuing. And if they want to continue in a power, then they have to be re-elected by the people. Why only for 5 years? Why not for continuingly? Because if people don't like the government which were elected previously, in the next election they can deny that government through the voting and elect the other government which would work better for them. Hence in India the government elected for 5 years only, or the elections in a regular intervals of 5 years only. Now next way of participation, there are the other ways we already discussed. Like if we see here the signature campaigns, you know very well what is the signature campaign. Like here in the above image, you see the stop violence against the women, and the people came together and they give a signs. You do same things in the class sometimes also. If you don't like some of the decisions, you all of you students came together and make a sign and give to the principal and other. In this way we can say this is the signature campaign. So the protest, the railway privatization, nowadays we all of you know that Modi government doing the privatization of the railway, which is the government most important organization, PSU we can say, public sector company. But the government wants to privatization, so the employees start to do the protest or the signature campaign against that decision. Next, the rallies and protest. Now students, you know the latest example, that is the CAA bill, okay, or CAB we can say. What is mean by the CAA? Citizen Amendment Act, okay. The government make a changes in that act, that is the Citizen Amendment Act, and CAB is also cap there, Citizen Amendment Bill. So the Citizen Amendment Bill present in the parliament for changes, bring the changes in the Citizen Amendment Act, Citizen Amendment Act. So people, or protest, rallies, and do the did the protest against that decision. So third, the mass media, whatever the decisions taken by the government, the people, the citizens having a number of means of mass media like television. Through the television news channels, people came and they discuss and they debate on that issue, that what is better, what is right and what is wrong. Second, newspaper, through the newspaper people give their opinion. Third, the magazines, through the internet, through the posters, through the leaflets, through the radios. Like if the government take a good decisions, they announce it through the radio, like the Modi use that radio Akashvani nowadays, okay. And another, that is the mass media. And everyone nowadays, we are techno friendly, and the people use these social sites like Facebook, Twitter, WhatsApp, etc., and gives their opinion against that decision, if it is good or better, whatever. So in this way, the people participate through the government, participate in the government decision or government process. Role of democratic government. So students, while the conflict arises in the nation, at that time the democratic government plays a vital role to resolve that conflicts. What is mean by the conflict? Conflict means the clashes among the people, between the groups, among the groups. So conflict occurs when people of different culture, religions or economic backgrounds do not get along with each other, or when some among them feel they are being discriminated against. Means while the people are not treated equally, or sometimes the people also feel that they are being discriminated against one or another. So at that time, so conflicts leads to fear, tension and sometimes violence also, and hence the government role is to resolve the conflicts, to solve the conflicts. Conflicts and differences have to resolve according to constitutional laws that have to be followed by everyone. And government solve that conflicts, they need to use the constitutional laws, and that everyone before that laws are equal. No one will be superior. Government need to resolve the conflict. So here the example, Kaveri river water dispute between the Karnataka and Tamil Nadu state. We know that the Kaveri river originate in Karnataka or merge or drain in Bay of Bengal. So hence this river flow through the Karnataka and Tamil Nadu. So which kind of conflict arises between them? So student, Rajasagar Dam, which were built in Karnataka, and Methur Dam, built in Tamil Nadu. So the downstream dam in Tamil Nadu can only be filled when water released from Rajasagar Dam, because this river flow from Karnataka to Tamil Nadu. So first the Rajasagar Dam will be filled, then later while the it completely filled, then water released from it, and then the Methur Dam will be filled. So both the state can get as much as water as need for the people in their states. So in this way the conflict arises because in the Karnataka, through the Rajasagar Dam, the stored water is used for irrigating the land, as well as also the metropolitan city Bengaluru. Means the water which needed to the Bengaluru city, which provided by the Rajasagar Dam. And Tamil Nadu, the water used through the Methur Dam for the purpose of irrigation of the delta land. So when the dispute arises, when the conflict arises between these two states, then central government by equal distribution of water for both states. Now Equality and justice. Equality and justice are the key ideas of a democratic government, and which are inseparable from each other. Justice can achieved when people are treated equally. Government make a special provisions or laws for groups that are equal. Example, untouchability ban by law. And other example, that school fees of girl child is waived or lowered in a government school or colleges, as well as the government need to uplift the people who were were not treated equally. Also provide the equal share of the resources of the country, give the equal opportunity in the government jobs. For that, the government give the reservation to the backward societies for applying the ideas of the government. Thank you.